Hey, Melanin Nation, Melanin Gang, what's poppin'? I know it's been a long time, but I'm just coming here with a tutorial. And I'm looking a little crazy as usual, because y'all know me. I'm that goddess that keep it real 100% of the time. What you see is what you get. But, right now, I'm just putting a scrub on my face. I'm using the St. Ives Blackhead Clearing Scrub. This is the green tea and bamboo. And I'm just putting this on my face because I've been wearing makeup these last couple days because Halloween was just a couple days ago. And today everybody's voting and all that. So I'm just sitting here doing my little self-care. Get my full moon energy. Today I might be doing a makeup tutorial because my makeup came out so bomb, you guys. And I know I've been saying for like the whole time I had my channel that I was going to do like in-depth just, you know, makeup. Not the whole get ready with me, but this probably still is going to be a get ready with me because I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial. I'm going to put on my other wig so y'all can see the full effect and post some pictures from Halloween and stuff of how it came out. And then you're going to see how it looks now. Because I'm going to be wearing the same wig. And then we're going to be washing a wig. And I'm just looking in the camera, y'all. Because I don't have my my flip mirror. It's still at my other place. So, yeah. But I finally got the vanity here. So, right now we're just sitting at the vanity. So, I gotta go back and move some other stuff. We'll get there. Nah, this stuff, it smells so good. I even use this sometimes on other parts of my body. Because it's just that good. And I haven't really been making my own products. Like, I took a break from here. And life has just been crazy. I just been real water sign just going with the flow of everything. And now it's the end of the year and I'm just trying to, you know, get back to moving, you feel me? You know, start putting in that energy for the new year and shit, you feel me? And ladies, if you're wearing makeup, just make sure you get down in that nose, because I hate when I get pimples right here. Because y'all know me, I really don't break out besides my little one pimple when I do have a cycle. If you are following me on my health journey or woman's health blog, whatever you're gonna call it, you know that I really wasn't breaking out like that because I really wasn't getting the cycle due to a combination of things, but I just wanna stay on topic. So yeah. If you're new to my channel, you know, go check it out. We do everything on here. Oh, also, y'all, today I might do a DIY too. Because I have like a whole bunch of pants and stuff that I don't wear and I just don't want to just throw them away because I'm then gave away a whole bunch more clothes, you guys. Then I went and donated some more clothes. So you want to just rub that until it gets like a little bit of dryness to it. And I didn't wet my face first. I just went full in. I do have my spin brush, but for some reason it's like stupid. Like, I even put new batteries in it and it's still acting dumb. But you can still use it if it's not working. And I also have like one of these you can get from like Dollar Tree or something. And these work really, 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 really good too. And don't come from right now, y'all. It was Halloween. Came into the nail shop. Don't come from me. So, yeah. So, we're gonna go wash this off. Brush my teeth and stuff. I just got out the shower and stuff not too long ago. So, yeah. And we're gonna exfoliate our lips and all that. So, when we put on our makeup, it's on. So I'll see you in just a second. So I just went in with my spin brush twice everywhere around my face. And I went in twice with the white towel. I get everywhere. Then rinse out the towel and I go over again. Also, when you're doing your lashes, if you're a girl that sleeps in your lashes, you're not used to that, or you're worried about taking them off because you struggle or have a hard time putting them back on, you don't want to take them off, all you have to do is pull a towel on your eye, wipe the lid down, and then what you want to do is hold your finger under it, and then you wipe the tops gently, and then put your finger on the back of it, and then wipe up under gently, and that'll save your lashes. Also, I use hair glue, which is the 30-second bond glue for my lashes, and they usually last about a week, if not longer. Sometimes I take them off, or if they just lift on the edge, I'll take the back of the tweezers and just lift it up, put a little glue, and attach it back. Yes, it's a little process, not as easy as it sounds, but that's what I do if I don't feel like taking off the whole lash. Also, I will be using the Nourishing Body Care Beauty Cream by Dove. I had picked this awesome product up at Dollar Tree, and I've been using it for like the last 2 months or so. I don't know what happened to my other one. I had two of them, but and when I don't use that, I still have my Elle Avenue Cosmetics lotion, and this smells uber, uber good. I'll probably have to order some more because I had got that like a while ago in a package thing. And y'all know me, I really don't use a lot of products on my face because I make a lot of my own products. And I really have sensitive skin, so I don't like, if, you know what I'm saying, don't fix what's not broken type of thing. And I just get up under my eyes really good, make sure that's moisturized. Another thing I use, if you've been following the channel, you already know, I use a lot of castor oil in my products and on my face. On my skin, a lot of coconut oil, so that's another reason why I be having products for like ever, because people buy them for me for gifts, or I just test it out and yeah, forget about it. And then it's like just stills in the moisture, like kind of like how Aveeno feels, almost, when Aveeno seals your skin in. Also, and for the lips, because I also like to condition those before makeup. If I can find it, it should be right here, and it's not, so where did I put it? Yeah, it might be in my purse. Some cherry comments, because I don't feel like getting up, even though I already get up in a second anyways, but I just got that on there. I did exfoliate my lips. This is gonna further condition them. So we'll let all that sit in while we're doing the foundation part. Also, the wig that I'm going to be redoing is not that one. Ooh, she right here. She looks crazy too. Lord have mercy. Yeah, this is the right one. So yeah, I throw away a lot of that hair weave and stuff too. If you have watched my, you know, project cleanup
tour of my house, get ready with me, or clean up with me. Y'all know I had like a whole bunch of hair, but I used a lot of it up and then I threw away a lot of it. So this is my synthetic one wig. I took a lot of pictures in this, but I have to be online, so I'll insert some. But we're gonna be fixing her up. I forgot how long she is. I think this is, I wanna say it's a 30 inch. And she was like 70 at my local beauty supply. I can see like she needs some tender loving care. So we're gonna be doing a cold wash on this hair. And I am going to be using, if I can find it, some like everywhere. Like the conditioners and soaps and stuff that I'm buying when I work at the hotel, because them folks will be buying some good stuff and you have to leave it and be like, for what? This is the anti-breakage therapy. I was using this for my real hair at one point. I might put that on there afterwards to seal some of that moisture. This is the shampoo. Some of these spilled out. This is a conditioner. And what you want to use is a conditioner, because that's going to seal back in the moisture. Okay, and this is some of the hotel conditioner. So I'm going to mix some of the conditioner from the hotel I used to work. It's all nasty because some of the stuff spilled out, so I'm going to rinse that off. And we have the Suave Moisturizing Conditioner. This has almond and shea butter in there. And then this is a 2-in-1 shampoo and conditioner. And this stuff from my hotel, it smells so good. Like, the room to stink, I'll put it in the toilet. I'll be down and then I'm cleaning. By the time I come back down there, this would have the whole room smelling uber amazing. So, and you want your hair to smell uber amazing, so why not? And then it has a little bit of shampoo in it, so it won't be too much shampoo. So we can still get the disinfecting properties that we need, because we are going to be washing this in cold water. And what you are going to want to do is, before you do anything, you want to get you a paddle brush. Okay. And this chair is so loud. So yeah, you want to get you a little padded brush. And you're gonna start from the ends of the hair, like this. So good thing she's already ponytailed up. If your hair is not in a ponytail, please put it in a ponytail. Because it's gonna save you like so much time and stress management for doing this. Because if you just put this hair in the water, and you take it out and it's wet, it's gonna be super, super tangled. And then when it dries, it's gonna be matted. And you don't want that. So you want to make sure that ponytail is, you see how bad she looks already? And this is with no heat, no nothing. This is a synthetic blend hair. Yeah. Still got a little nap. So I thought we were about to fix her. So then you want to slide that ponytail down. Also, if you stick your hair in there, see how all up on the neck is nappy? So yeah, and then also another reason is because if you do that, if the hair starts shedding, you're going to be pulling out so much hair from the lace part, because this is a partial lace loop at the top. And you don't want to rip your legs. I'm going to get in the back of that neck real quick, because that irritates me, so you know, anybody going to do it, but I don't like that. this is the part where I said the lighting has lace on it. So you don't wanna rip the lace. That's what I mean by a partial lace. So you want to just hold it in the middle with your thumb and start from the top and then work your way down. When you go down, do smaller strokes because all the tangles are going to be there, but you already combed out over that part. Just move your thumb out the way. Oh, look, she's starting to look better now already compared to this side. And this is just brush and heat. I'm sorry, for some reason my camera went out and I had to delete stuff off my phone. So I just went ahead and applied my short wig that I've been wearing for like the last couple of days. I really like it, didn't get a lot of compliments on it. And some people are like, that's that granny wig, but I don't hate it. In the back, it's just short. I don't like tapering my sides, so this is just for the tutorial. But if I was to really be going out, I would use my True Edge, and when I put on my cap, I would slick all that up, and I would slick down my sideburns and stuff to make sure that it's real secure and flat with the cap. But okay, y'all, so recording on the phone is just not going to work, so if the picture's a little bit fuzzy, I'm sorry, but we had to switch to the little bootleg tablet because that's the only way I can just edit my videos, I guess, and that's just the way it's gonna be. So that's just what it is. If y'all hear the TV in the back, I'm sorry. I was watching this video, so that's just is what it is. But while I was trying to wait for this tablet to charge everything, I went ahead and pushed her all the way out. And this is what we have so far. I also went ahead and got the crimper out because we're going to be crimping this. We have a towel so that way for the drying process, I don't want to get water everywhere all over my vanity. We still got the paddle brush out because this is what we're going to be using for after the hair is washed. I have a hair polish. This is the Do Grow. I don't have this since forever. I really don't use it. Like I said, y'all seen my tour. I just like to shop, and I had a lot of shit, and yeah. So, I like to put this on the hair because it locks in the moisture, it locks in the shine, and I like to use it in a pump squeeze bottle instead of the can bottle because the air from the can makes the synthetic hair fray and be real puffy and nasty looking at the ends, and as you see, my ends are very smooth, so we don't want to tear the hair up. Then we're gonna have to start cutting it and all of that. Also, while I was waiting, I went ahead and got the mannequin head out. It already has some pins in there, and I'm just gonna set the wig on there to dry on top of the towel. So we're not gonna towel dry it a lot, we're just gonna wring out the hair. So what you are going to want to do first is, if you're not going to set this on your head first, and you do have a mannequin, you just want to take your mannequin, take like two pins out, or you take all of them right here, matter of fact. And then we're not going to use all of them. And I'm thinking I'll cut some baby hairs on it because I never cut the baby hairs on it in the first place. And then they have to be on their super perfect because I was going to slash it. You want to go through again with a little light brush. Just get most of the things out. Again. Okay.
actually trying to do. So after you do that, we're gonna be putting this into two areas. OMG, that's probably why I'm not freaking tapping out. She's freaking out and dropped this bitch like 1,000 times. I'm just gonna stick a paint at the top and split this down the middle. And I have two little hair ties right here. So after you get it split down the middle, split that to the side. I'm struggling because I don't have a stand. So I was like, I'm going to set this on your head. You can, but I'm not going to call that. And all I'm going to do is lightly do a three-strand braid, which is a basic. And when I say loosely, I mean not too loose to where the hair is going to get shaggy when you dip it in the water, but loose enough to not where it's going to leave so many crimps in the hair, or come straight out as soon as you put it in there. But you want to be able to rinse all the product from that conditioner out, because we're not going to put the conditioner straight on the hair, we're putting the conditioner in the actual water. And I braided it down about like this far. And as you see, the braid is not super, super tight. It's fairly loose. And we got some ends left out. And I'm just gonna put rubber band in. I'm gonna rubber band that. I remember banding it like 3 times because when the hair gets in the water, it's going to get thinner and I don't want the rubber band to come off. So we just rubber banded it 3 times and let this much hair fall out. Pin off the floor so nobody steps on it. While we have our wig setting, we're going to move on to the makeup for this look that I have right now.
When you're washing your wig, you don't want to scrub it, you just want to pat down. When you're washing your wig, you don't want to scrub it, you just want to pat down.
Okay, y'all. I swear, I'm going to need a drink after this tutorial because I just feel so rusty and crusty from doing this. The editing process is still a struggle. As far as, like, recording and this memory stuff and all of that, like, I'm just over it. So, I had took a clip, but I'm not sure if I'm going to put it in here or not. On my phone, because my phone is still acting kind of crazy. So what I did was I filled up the sink with water, then I squirted in my conditioners, swirled all of that around, then I took the braided wig and I submerged it all the way in the water and folded it over while the hair is in the water, is sitting like this. I don't scrub or do none of that. I just press gently. I pick it up put it back in the water, flip the hair, and press. And I do that about a couple times until the water turns as black as it's gonna get. Once I see the water is not getting any blacker, I just let the wig actually just sit there for a good 5-10 minutes. And then I open up the wig, and on the part where the laces is, I just try to rub my fingers across that, or like the base of my thumb. Nothing too crazy or anything like that. And as you see, that's why I said I don't want to put the hair in there loose, because these are where the shorter hairs are at. And you see how it's all frizzy? That's why you don't want to scrub your hair when it's in the water. Okay, then for the rinsing process, it's basically the same thing. You let all the water out. You fill the sink up or you just let it run. I turn on both of my nozzles. That way I can get the water the perfect warm temperature, but mainly cold, if that makes any sense. And then I just, you know, squish the hair. And if the water doesn't turn black, I just do that a couple times to make sure, you know, there's no going to be no residue in my hair or anything like that. Then what I do is I pick it up out of the water. No, I'm taking down the braid as I'm telling y'all this, but yeah, y'all get it. I pick it up out the water and I hold it by the top of the hair like this. And I just wring it out like this and go down. And I do that until most of the water is all the way out and nothing else is really coming out. After all the water is mainly out, that's why I like a bath towel about this size or whatnot. And I use this for some other stuff this week. That's why it has a little bit of stuff on it. But for the most part, it's clean. Don't trip. So, you want a bath towel about this size. This is one of the towels I got from the hotel as well that they use for floor mats. So, something about that size. You want to take it from the top of the towel and just fold over once. You're going to lay it on a flat surface. And then you just press down. And that's going to help the hair from dripping at the ends so much. And then it's not really, you know, rubbing on the hair, but it's getting all of the water out. And this is the same process I do for my natural hair. I do not rub the towel on my hair. I gently just squeeze, and before I lift my head up from the sink, I pull all my hair up into a ponytail and I wring out my hair most that it can wring out. So I do treat my weave how I treat my actual hair. Okay, for this part right here, you just want to just untangle it a little bit. That way you can keep your portions separated. So what I'm going to do is, now that this is damp, I'm going to take my hairspray oil and I'm just going to spray down the whole thing. So make sure you get those ends real good. And oh my god, this hair smells so good, you guys. I wish you guys could smell it. We're doing this while it's damp, so we can brush it. And when it dries silky. You don't want nappy, straggly, ugly hair, but it's not cute. Just because you're balling on a budget, don't mean you gotta look like you're on a budget, okay? And I got on black clothes, something that I don't really care about. I don't see why people be coming on here with a brand new outfit just to get messy hair. Like, that's just not my thing. Whatever floats your boat. Because when I step out, if he steps out, okay. You see how silky that is? She looks brand new all over again. Gonna do is go to the other side. Matter of fact, we can just spray it while it's on the braid. But I can make sure I get both sides, everything is even. Get the top and the front. Also, I don't mind putting grease because I really don't glue my wigs down. My wigs all come with combs in them. And my head is so little. Like it'd be stuck to my head. Peanut head girls. I'm just brushing on top of the towel to just catch any of that excess hair. Yes, baby. This hair smells so good. Let's see. Ooh. See how the brush just glide? That's what you want. So, not bad for the synthetic boy, okay? What I'm gonna do is get our mannequin head back out and set her back up on there. Also, if you are the type of girl who glues your wigs down, after you do this process and it air dries fully, and the oils and everything have set in there, you can go back in on your lace line with a towel, not a cotton ball, because cotton ball can tear up. But you want to get a towel, preferably like a dark color, and just go in with some rubbing alcohol or get some alcohol swabs, pad things, and just, you know, clean it up and stuff. Bitch, okay. Well, I can't wait to put the crimps on her. So I'm just gonna set her across the towel so she can dry. Oh, shit. I'm struggling, y'all. Oh, it's got her sitting up there like okay. And I'm so geeked about this hair. I don't even know if I even want to do makeup. But, guess what? Yeah, at least we can do some lips or something. Because I really don't feel like putting on foundation or anything. It's like, it's taking forever. And then the way my editing process is going, it's like, it's pissing me off. And I feel like it's not going to come out right. And here go my blue sets right here the whole time. So, I'm just going to go back over. Because in the process, when I was getting my teeth and stuff clean, washed the hair, I did eat some pizza. I just woke up, you guys, and I just woke up like, I just gotta do a story, so that's how I just ended up just doing my facial stuff, y'all. So, yeah. I'm gonna do my lips. I like to get out my colorless powder, which I ended up getting this from a group of people that had some stuff at the hotel as well. And they were like with a theater group. They were like a theater group. I'm sorry, I had to put my charger back on here. This is so irritating. See, and y'all see why I don't even want to do my foundation now. Why is it pausing like that? I'm sorry. Okay. There we go. Alright. So, I like to put this on last for my lips. And I also put this on, which is the setting spray by e.l.f. I think I'm gonna do like a brown today. I really been using like this purple. It looks lavender, but it comes out like super mauve-y. I think it's right here in my purse. Let's see. Yep. And lip gloss are look at God trying to help us this time. Okay. So, we have our Blistex one. And what I like to do is, I like to take my darkest brown pencil. And all of this stuff is drugstore makeup or get it from the dollar store. Whatever floats your boat. Because, like I said, since we be doing this on a budget. So, I'm going to slide a little bit out the way. Because, again, we are at the vanity. And I'm going to slide my camera down a little bit. So my angle can be right and I can look into the tablet as my mirror. And you just want to line your lips. And I cannot wait to show you my era. But I can show y'all the products that I did use. And like I said, I'm going to insert the pictures. It's just that, like I said, I woke up and just wanted to do a tutorial. But now, the way that this is going, I don't think I want to. Because I feel like a lot of footage is probably going to cut out. And I don't like the writing on this tablet. Like I said, this is the Maybelline New York. This is number 35. Is it really 35 creator? What does the other one say? It's not even the same brand. Okay, yep, because the brown one is 85 protector. And this one is 35. Yes, ma'am. Gonna be on YouTube? Yeah, get your ass back in here, man. He's so nosy, y'all. I'm just looking at my mirror that's sitting up here. I have a main mirror. So I'm gonna be like, what the fuck is she looking at? That's what it is. That's another reason too, because I'm like, I want to make sure that my angles is right. I used to just vlog it for y'all and not really do makeup. And usually when I do my makeup, I would have my lipsticks already sitting on there. Then I would go over it. Like after I do my foundation, my eyeshadow and stuff, I would go over my lips with foundation and then go in with my lipstick. And that makes it last even longer because everything is gonna melt and mold together. But like I said, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just showing y'all how I got my lips. So I can just get an idea. I really don't, because if I'm gonna do something, I just want to make sure it's right for y'all. And then I have my Juicylicious Mouth Watering Gloss, Mango Butter, and Acai Berry. And this is Plum Seduction from my local beauty supply. And this is tinted a little bit. See how that just blacked out on y'all? That's what I'm talking about. I don't want to do a whole tutorial and then it's doing stupid shit like that. You see how dark it just made my lips again? But that's all good. Because what we're going to do is I'm going to go back on with that liner and get it act dark. I do like my little space. I can't wait to make so many memories with y'all guys right here. I'm just gonna lighten it back up. Like with that lipstick. Is matte. I just like to lick the insides of my lips because a lip gloss on the teeth is not cute lately. So now that we got that, like that, the gloss is just to keep it hydrated, to keep it from cracking. And I go in with my colorless powder. And it's just gonna matte and everything back up. And like I said, I got this from people that were doing theater. And they left like a whole bunch of makeup and stuff for my tip that they didn't want. Or was on a throwaway. And I was seeing if we had wanted it before they threw it away. And you know me, even at the time, I really wasn't doing makeup, but I was like, well, I don't know. It's free, it's colorless, and I don't know. I needed to set stuff, so why not? So, whatever else does not blend in, all I do is hold my lips together. And I just set the whole day for your lips. If you want. Yeah. I'm a heavy lip liner girl. To me, lips don't look right unless they're lined. Hey. In Florida in South Beach at one of the boutiques. It's called Sunkissed Trio Bronzer Malibu Glitz. I think I showed this in some of my other tutorials. And yes, y'all, I have my page for like 2 years and I still have it. This one I barely even use. It's still brand new. This one got cracked a little bit. This one I mainly use because it has all those pretty pinks and stuff and bronze colors. And all I really do, y'all, is I rub right there. And on a circle. See how that just brightens up everything? Okay. And now we're gonna go down the nose. And if I start sniffing, y'all, it's because I'm allergic to my makeup. Like, I like it, but I'm allergic to it. I like to put a little right here above my glasses just to accentuate, you know, my eyelashes and stuff. Just bring some light to right there. Because why not? Like, what? And I like to just rub it in, that way it warms up with the skin. You're not just looking like you're ashy and glowing at the same time, but it's not blended. So I would normally just do that over my foundation. I'm not gonna do no brows, because I really don't need them. But this is something that you could do just to spice up your look. Just lashes, a bold lip, and a little highlight on your chin and on your nose, and boom. Okay? If you want to put some more satin spray over it, you're more than welcome to. But I know that I'm not really going away with that. And I just got a fucking highlighter in my hair. And my hair is like, it's slightly damp. It's not even really. No heat on. don't know if I want to go through with the heat and actually okay, my bad. I was trying to get it to where y'all could see me do the actual baby hairs. I'm just going in real lightly. And barely pulling anything out. I'm doing this with my pinky now. If you want, you can use a clipper right to the front. And I'm only going to like about here. But I really don't. You don't gotta be perfect because nobody's baby hairs are even. What size is always gonna be thicker? But you wanna get it remotely close so it's not like super off. Mm-hmm. Mercy. sticky. Up to 430, but I got it on 400. Yeah. So it was that back section was out. One hand is for some polishment, three squirts on the top, the middle, and one at the ends, and brush through. Also, if you have a styrofoam head, be careful that you're not getting too close to it. And then back layer, I'm just one whole segment. Okay. It's not burning my hair. And it's going to make sure. turn it on a higher setting. I have to put some hairspray on it due to it has a synthetic hair in there. Because it's acting like it's taken to the heat, but it won't take to the curl. I really don't like hairspray in my hair. Just making it. Ugh. I'm just gonna look at like a wave. I think the hair might be a little damp, and that's probably why it's not taking how it wants to. Tell y'all what I'm gonna do. So each section I'm going through is gonna be two tracks. Like I did for this one, so it'll be next two tracks, next two tracks, next two tracks. And once I get to a certain point with curling, because like I said, I think I'm gonna have to wait for the hair to get a little bit drier because it's lightweight damp, but for the most part dry. And I need my curler to get way hotter than what it is. Because as you can see, it only did a tiny tap of it. And if I end up going in with a little hairspray, I'll let you know and show you the actual hairspray that I used. Because I don't want to use the insta. And I'm going to use something that's in a pump bottle and it still smells good. So the one that I might go for is my oldie but goodie, and that's the olive oil hairspray. And I'm just putting little clips on the side so that way the hair doesn't get mixed in with that hair. They sell them in the local supply store for $1.50, so can't go wrong with that. $1.50 Why not? So I'm gonna try one cream. She's just spacing down one time. Being good. Let's see. that's sitting on the counter. It's just sitting on there. And it's so weird, it's not gonna melt the actual plastic of the styrofoam, but it's sitting up on there. So it's like hours later. The struggle was real. I finally got her all crimped. Kind of don't like how it came out, but it's like a loose leaf. Bro, I want to do crimp kind of. It is what it's going to be. It's getting all super defined.
Wait,
it's all good. And I just got on my phone, I used the tropical roots, and that's what I'm going to be using for the baby hairs. Instead of using gel, because the gel is going to cake up and flake up, and I don't want that. So, just going to take the pin inside. And yes, yeah, I'm going to make my cocktail, because I'm going to tell you. Shit, I'm going to drive me nuts. Noise in the background. That's just the kids playing. Playing on my game. Let them do them. That's okay. Ciao. Ooh, just one pin. Oh, it's another one.
Oh, now we're working.
Okay. I feel like it's another pin. I said, you guys, this is going to get to my head kind of snug, so I'm not going to glue it. I'm just going to put the combs in on my braids. There's two combs right here and one comb in the back. So I'm going to get this across my lap. We're going to remove this wig. The hair isn't that. I just hate the little hairs on my neck. They're always in the way. Okay, my hair's in the front, it's out the way as possible. I like to cut the back of my head first, like the middle, and then look. I'm ready to see how it's gonna fit. And then I put my comb in the back so that it's sturdy and not sliding around. Let me fix that at the top. And then we're just gonna slide these combs up right there like so. And under my cap, I just have like four little basic braids. Nothing crazy, nothing spectacular. And I'm just looking in the mirror that's behind y'all. Except for looking like I'm looking at someone crazy. Don't mind it.
When you put
it in the battery and it's down like, if it will come in off the different depth. I'm sure I did. I mean, not my lashes, but my eyebrows. Okay. And boom. I'm about to just go back in the kitchen. I mean, not the kitchen, but the bathroom here. Because the lighting is better in there. I am in the hallway. I don't like it. It's cute. I look so different with longer hair. It's crazy. just need to make sure that the top is dispersed out. I'm supposed to. I don't even think I'm going to even gel my ears, so I really don't need it. I'm not up far enough because I do have a widow's peak, so I just like to bring it up a little bit on my forehead. And for each strand, I did go through because the hair was wet because we washed it. So when you're working with synthetic fibers, even though the outside might be dry, the inside of the synthetic fiber isn't. So the curls were taking a long time to take. I think that's why they came out so loose. But nevertheless, like I said, it's like a little lightweight beach curl. And I only really went over the ends, like the very tips of my hair with the flat iron. That way, it'll be easier for the crimper to mimic the fibers. And just put 3 pumps of this and went back in with 3 pumps of this and brushed it with the paddle brush before I started crimping. And yeah. Melanination, Melanin Gang, I'm going to pop in and take it over.